is Tony Park, and I am a clarinetist here in New York City. Today we are going to go through each of the steps that you need to take to put a clarinet together and hopefully be able to make a sound out of it. Okay, let's get to it. So here's my clarinet case. Has clarinet in it. And usually the top of the case, where the instrument is facing upwards, is smaller than the bottom, I guess, of the case. As in, if you open your case, the latch is going this way, for the most part, not always, but for the most part, you are going to open it the wrong way. And I'll show you what I mean by the wrong way. So if you open it like this, all the keys, these are facing upwards and we're okay. And why is it a big deal if we don't open it the right way? Well, because I really shouldn't do this, but when you do this, your instrument can like immediately roll around and kind of go everywhere. And you know, clarinet has very complex mechanisms all over the body, and you don't want to hit the joints and things and damage the keys, the wood or the plastic, whatever your clarinet's made of. So what you want to do, I'm just going to put this aside here. Oop, there's a reed. Okay. Bell, lower joint, oops, upper joint. Okay. So let's try that again. Case, open, small side, big side, right? So when you open the clarinet case, you should find a two long sticks, I guess. Let's call them sticks. Okay, so one is a little shorter than the other one. Okay, so the longer one goes under the shorter one. Okay, so this one is called the lower joint. This is the upper joint. Okay. So the way you put that together is you want to wrap your hand around the body where there are no keys. And you don't want to push any of these up. You just want to cover them naturally because they're meant to go down anyway. Cover them like this. And you don't want to do this onto the rod here, like this. And then you want to grab on the upper joint. See these? Empty, full, empty, right? The circles here. You want to push down the second empty one, which will pull down both of these, put that down, and which would raise this bridge mechanism here. It's called the bridge mechanism because it bridges the mechanism here eventually. And if I click this on the lower joint, oh wow, they connect. So that's why that's called the bridge mechanism, but we won't get into that too much right now. So the reason, well, maybe we will just now. Okay, so the reason why we can't just put this in like this is that sometimes you can hit the keys, this key to like this or this, and bend that. And this regulation, as in regulation is the relationship between the upper joint and the lower joint, if that is thrown out, a lot of the times it might not matter. But if you are, let's say, using certain fingerings that you might not normally use for, in clarinet world, we might call that alternative fingering or auxiliary fingering. And that might not work because that specific mechanism is out. So anyway, so let's go back and review. Okay, lower joint, the longer one, upper joint, right? Wrap around the body and you push this and also wrap around the body like this. Okay. And then what you want to do, you don't want to go like in like this or like this. You want to go straight into it as straight as you can. So don't rush this process because you can actually really damage the tendon and the joint. So you want to kind of rotate like this and make sure this is all greased well, and I'll show you how to do that later in a video. Just kind of rock, not rock, just kind of rotate like this, and then you want to find the middle of this mechanism with this thing. So these line up in a line here. Okay, so that's good. It looks like that. All right, so that's the body of the clarinet. So what else is left? We have a bell and a barrel. Okay, I don't know if everyone knows what a barrel is, but it looks like this. This looks like a barrel, so we call it a barrel. And this looks like a bell, so we call it a bell. Wow, big brain time. So we grab the body of the clarinet, grab the bell, so, and then you have almost the full body of the clarinet. And some people, you know, they like to attach the bell first onto the lower joint, and that's totally fine. That's totally fine. I'm just used to doing this this way. So grab the bell. Barrel. Grab the barrel. I'm such a bad teacher. Grab the barrel. Lower joint. Again, everything in rotation. Okay. And one of the reasons why we do it by rotation is because it's the least damaging way. And also, if you look at this tendon here, we create a good seal between two pieces by having cork in there. This cork is really compressed, but usually it's a little bit poofier here, so that when you push down here, it creates this airlock vacuum, more or less a vacuum. Okay, now, if we go straight like this, what happens is that over time, the cork gets pushed down, and then it can break this piece of cork off the joint, which is not a big deal. You can replace it, or your nearest repairman or repairwoman can, but that's not ideal. You want this to last as long as possible, because if we don't have this is going to be an empty kind of there's a groove in there, so this is going to rock. So you absolutely need this cork there. So don't try to take this off, please. Don't do it. Something like this. Okay? So let's review it again. I'm a big reviewing teacher. So grab the lower joint, grab the bell. I guess I did it another way before, but lower joint, upper joint, rotate. Line up the bridge mechanism, okay, and we have the barrel here. Is this everything? Almost. So what we have here also, we have a mouthpiece, we have a flat side of the mouthpiece, this is called a table, and on the table we want to take a reed and put this part of the reed after wetting it with your mouth. Don't suck the moisture out of it, you have to put the moisture in it. And then you put it on the mouthpiece like this, and then you put your ligature like so. Tighten it. And ligatures come in all different shapes and forms. So if yours doesn't look like this, don't freak out. It's okay. Just make sure that your adjusting knob should be on your right side. Sorry, left-handed people. There are very few ligatures out there that have this on the left side for left-handed people. But I'm sorry, the world is not really made for the left-handed people. Anyway, so grab this. Put it, and then you do the same thing onto the barrel. Mm-hmm. And And sometimes it is easier actually to put this on here first and then read here. And then like this. Okay. Or another way, you could have the ligature here. Read here, and what you want to do is that you want to adjust the left and right with the thumb here and your thumb, right hand, left hand thumb on the bottom of the reed, right hand thumb here, and then you just want to kind of adjust with your thumb here and your index pointer finger here, just kind of going and then you want to put it in the middle of the table. And then you want to raise the reed like so, you're using this thumb, carefully going up. And you want to make it flush. What does flush mean? It's not toilet related. It's actually a carpenter term where this, the edge of that has to be at the edge of that. It has to be perfectly... true, like that. Okay, so that's about it. Okay, so what are we gonna do now? We're gonna review it. So take this all off carefully. I'm just kind of speeding it up just for the sake of your time. Okay, so lower joint, wrap around, bell, rotate, never speed this process up, okay? Upper joint, bridge mechanism, boom. Here, mouthpiece. I think I was using this reed. With the reed. Put it on the mouthpiece. Take the ligature. Carefully slide it. Adjust the reed so that it's in the center and it's not too high or too low. Then it will be very difficult to play if it's too high or too low. Okay? All right, so that's how you put a clarinet together. And if you blow on it, it'll make a sound. But that's for a different video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys again in the future videos. Thanks.